Hello, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to RTC TV 4. My name is Dakota Hayden. Alongside with me, my co-commentator and cameraman, Maddox Zider. How you doing, Maddox?
I'm pretty good.
It's good. Tonight's matchup for girls varsity basketball, we have our Lady Comets versus the North White Vikings. Should be an interesting matchup tonight. I'm predicting a win, but we'll have to see what happens here tonight.
Sounds like the student section was actually singing happy birthday to someone.
It is actually Megan Evans' birthday. Our number... I'm going to feel bad. Three. Vikings taking control of the ball, passing it back and forth, trying to get an opening. Comets just stay on him. Oh, went for a three. Well, that was almost a good one, too. Emily close on the rebound, sending it over to Evans. I want to see Evans pull some threes here. Getting it to Emily.
No foul.
There, that's for two.
Nice recovery.
That was a good recovery. Looking better than they did last week on those rebounds. Maybe it wasn't last week. It was earlier in the week. Tuesday. That's where it was. That's going to be out.
That was Krista with the deflection.
All right. Getting the ball put back into play. Vikings keeping the ball out, trying to find an opening. Trying to get some action moving. Ladies definitely moving a lot more than they were last time. Tuesday. I keep forgetting. It was Tuesday was the last time we were filming for a game. Oh, that was a nice three.
Splashing three ball right there.
All right, now we got Klein with the ball. Some movement. Pass down to three. Evans over to Bailey. Hooked. Trying to get over to Rome.
Just couldn't get a hold of it.
It's okay. We can recover from that. Vikings working on the offense here.
I think she was wide open right there, actually.
They're being really careful about who they pick for their shots. I forget who it was who made the three last time, but whoever it is, they better keep an eye on her. That was a nice one. There. Oh, she almost had it again. Number four, they got a
threes.
Yeah, number four, they got to watch number four. They're passing over to Hook. She's trying to wait for someone to get open. She's holding on to it. All right. Ball's going to be given to number three, Evans. Passed it over to Hook. Over to Evans again. She's almost had it with that layup. Rebound by Rowe.
Oh.
All right, now the Vikings got it. Oh, that layup was almost good. Got on travel. Comets got the ball. And a pass to Evans. Passing it to Hook. Back to Evans. Back again to Hook. Oh, they got stole.
Interception.
Watch four. She's going to go for a three. Or not. Pass it into the paint. Not getting anywhere. All right. Looks like we got number three, Megan Evans, up for the free throws. Oh, wait. I lied.
Free throws? What are you talking about?
I kind of misinterpreted that. I thought they were setting up for free throws, and I got really confused. Sorry. I'm all about the free throws.
I'm over here trying to adjust the camera. I hear someone's on the line. Now someone's on the line. Now you can say that.
Okay, now they're setting up for free throws, but
it's
I don't want North White setting up for free throws. Maybe she's no good. We'll find out. Somebody's got a horn out in the crowd. That was loud, but she made it anyway, so it was kind of counterintuitive.
I don't know who that was, but that was really loud.
Yeah. There she goes for her second one. She's one for one.
She's zero. Oh, no, she made that. Okay.
Yeah, she made the first one. All right.
She made it without the horn. Oh, with the horn, I mean.
Yeah. Evans passes over to Klein. Klein to Shane Lobb.
Oh,
swatted. Excuse me for my coughing. Still got a bit of a cold I'm recovering from.
Please don't give it to me.
I'm trying not to. Evans with the ball, rushing in up to Rowe. Nice shot. I think that leaves Rowe with both points scored tonight so far.
She's keeping him in the game.
Oh, yeah. Well, being 6 foot, she's a real good player. She's a real valuable player. Let me check my grammar on that one. Klein with the three attempt. Nice. That was a solid three. That was awesome. Vikings a little bit unorganized there on that shot attempt. They got the rebound but couldn't get anything out of it. Setting up for a free throw for the Vikings. Let's see how her game is. Oh, she made that one. Went straight in. See if she can do that again. Fires away. Oh, she made it. 2-0. Nice.
Brings him right back into it.
Yeah. Oh, hook was open. She was that open, but that was stolen. Getting up there. Man, they're getting really good in the movement. Rebounded. That got it in. That'll make the Vikings take the lead. Only by one, though. We can make that up.
Careful passing. We need some careful passing. Can't just be passing anywhere.
There you go. Evans to hook. Hook to Rowe. Travel. The Vikings ball. Can set up three attempt, missed it, rebounded, still
and
got
a foul.
The what was the foul? Did you catch that one?
Push. What was it? Shooting foul. Yeah, that's shooting foul.
All
basically,
right.
When they hit their arm, when they're trying to shoot and they hit their arm, it's a shooting foul.
Okay. She was on the free throw last time.
I must mistakenly called that a push. That's not a push.
Yeah. Timeout called. So, what do you think? What is your prediction for this game, Maddox? Since we got a timeout, you don't need to focus on the camera too much.
Since the score is kind of resembling a gas station right now, I really don't.
Oh, you're funny. You are funny.
I try to make the most out of a situation.
I know.
Can't really say anything until about the half.
True.
I do like the way the comments came out and then. They were really good. Like offense, their offense was really aggressive. Their defense needs to be more aggressive, and their passing game used to kind of, you know, not be more passive, but just select players better.
I agree fully. You're absolutely right. They're definitely moving a lot more than they were Tuesday, and that's really helping them out.
North White's starting to read where they're going to pass because they're going to read their eyes. So you got to be more careful about where you're passing the ball.
Exactly. Shane Lobb to Batchelor. Batchelor throwing it out to try and give it to Evans. She's got it.
Backcourt violation.
What was that?
Backcourt violation?
Yeah.
If you take it across the half court line and you bring it back on the other side and the other team hasn't touched the ball or like smacked it away from you or anything like that, it's a backcourt violation because you can't just go anywhere on the court once you pass the equator.
Right.
You can't go to the other side.
Right. Okay. Man, I'm so glad to have someone of, like, more than just basic basketball knowledge here.
Well, Galen would be here, but he's not here with us today.
Yeah. It helps having someone who knows a little bit more than the basics. Man, she's just down in those free throws.
She's a senior.
She is. That's her fourth one in fourth free throw that she's made.
Third.
Fourth. Third. No, yeah, third. Okay, maybe not. She's 3-1 now.
She's 3-4.
Yeah, 3-1. She made three, she missed one. Three attempt, no good.
Tried for another three and did not make that one.
I'm lost. Okay, here we go. Vikings at the ball. Trying to get an opening.
Cross-court pass right there. Ooh, she should have kept on to that.
She's good for it. Overshot. Is that a reach? Haha, I'm learning. Comet's got the ball now. Shane Lobb passes to Evans.
Evans is going to wait.
And then proceeds to pass to Klein, who proceeds to pass it back to Evans, then back to Batchelor.
See, they're being more selective.
Oh,
never mind.
Never mind. Get stolen.
Spoke too soon.
Oh, almost got restolen. Excuse me. Four going for the three again. She nailed that.
Ooh, I can hear it from here.
Yeah. Evans to Klein. Klein to Batchelor. Batchelor to Shane Lobb. Shane Lobb to Rowe. Rowe's up there for the shot, and she makes it.
I don't think I saw one dribble there.
Nope. All passing. Oh. Off the bounce side. Off the board. Evans has got it. There we go.
She is fast.
Back in. Go for the layup. Oh, she almost had it. No one for the rebound. Vikings got the ball. Bring it back. She's going to go for a three again, isn't she? Nope. Someone is. Yeah. No.
They're going to leave them open like that. They're going to take those shots, and eventually they'll make them.
Oh, yeah. You got to watch them. You know, decline like for the three attempt, and she didn't make it.
Ball's she out. Made one. She thinks that she can make another one. Over and over and over.
Well, at least she's trying for them. This is the.
That's true.
This has been the most three attempts that I've seen so far in girls basketball for us, anyway. And we've only done like three games prior.
Last game, I don't think we actually pulled 1-3.
I don't think we did either.
Which is good, because you're not really supposed to pull threes unless, you know, you're wide open like that, like right there.
Yeah, right there would have been a perfect time, but we don't want to tell them that. That's the opposing team. All right.
You got to have constructive criticism for your own team.
Yes. Shane Lobb throwing the ball to Batchelor. Batchelor going to throw it back to Shane Lobb. Doesn't receive it. Evans has got it. Brings it back around to Batchelor to Klein.
Another backcourt violation.
Hey, Vikings now regain control of the ball. No, earlier I wasn't thinking we were going to have that big of a student section, but it seems to be as big as it is every night that when it's
home. Well, they're screaming USA, which I don't know why.
We are a proud American school in the middle of a cornfield.
Well, we're all American.
I know we are, but we're proud of it.
Well,
not saying other people are not proud of it, but anyway. Batchelor throws the ball to Klein to Evans. Trying to keep in pace with the action here. Sounding really repetitive right now. Klein throws the ball to... Oh, is that Rowe? Rowe trying to go to Backman for the shot. Over to the Vikings. They're going to try and get open for a three. Like that. Oh, that...
Ooh,
nothing but threes, dude.
You can't, that's the third one tonight, I believe. Fourth one, maybe.
That's ridiculous. But impressive.
You can't leave them open like that. It's just not. It's almost the end of the first quarter. It's 22-9.
Oh man, Klein throws it over to Shane Love. I'm trying to get open, get it to Rowe. 6 seconds, 6.8 seconds left on the clock actually for the first quarter.
I think we've neglected to say that it is Coach Helmick's birthday today.
Oh, it is? Hold on, we got free throws by Rowe. Oh, first one, nice.
I don't know if it's Coach Helmick's or it's... You said it was Megan Evans, right?
Yes, it is her birthday today.
You were sure?
I did say about it, yes, I did.
I'm not sure if it's Coach Helmick. I don't know if Coach Helmick has a birthday today.
I have no idea. That was a nice voice crack, too.
I didn't notice.
Two for two. Oh.
I'm lying, I did notice.
That's okay, though.
Ooh, that was almost a nice steal. Holding him back.
Trying to keep him back.
Able to take the shot.
Haha, missed the almost full court shot. All right, well, that'll take us to the end of the first quarter. And I'm not even going to bother cutting it. Might as well just keep on and just, I don't know, be someone entertaining.
Treat like a timeout?
Oh,
treat it like a timeout?
Yeah, treat it like a timeout.
Usually we would just cut it off.
Yeah, but not, that's football. We're not going to cut it off here.
No, we cut it off for girls basketball, too. We did the first three games.
Eh, we'll treat it like a timeout.
We're different.
We are. I like to mix it up.
Oh. Let's take this time to shout out the cast and band.
They do a great job. They're definitely good at being loud, but they play really well for being loud.
Conducted by that man right there, Mr. Byrne.
He is a great band director. I should know, both Maddox and I play in the band, but we don't during games because we're here filming for the great RTC TV company.
And we're getting paid, woohoo.
Oh yeah, we are.
Have Mark Smith up there. You see him with a squid hat?
I started that squid hat thing.
You did?
Yeah. The purple squid hats were kind of like a, oh, I don't know what to call it, kind of like an upbringing ever since I wore the blue one. That started back when I had a concussion and I sat in with the band during a football game. And I didn't know what to do, so I brought a squid hat and wore it.
I didn't know what to do, so I brought a squid hat and I wore
it. That's exactly what I did.
It's the first thing you do when you don't know what's happening. You just bring a squid hat wherever.
Well, what
you're
else
going.
Am I supposed to do? Sit there and look pretty?
Well, that's a little too hard. Just bring a squid hat. You'll be fine.
Ouch. All right, we got the second quarter going here. Klein passing the ball to Shane Lobb.
Oh, pass it back out to Emily right there. Where are you going with it? It's going to be a foul. A pushing foul on number 20, Chris Shane Lobb, senior. This team's got a lot of seniors on it.
They do. I'm going to be interested. Well, I won't be able to know because I won't be around, but I'm going to be interested when they all graduate to who's going to fill in all the gaps.
Well, we do have one junior on the court right now. That's number 21, Ashlyn Klein. She just got the ball.
She's got the ball.
She's the one who made the three, by the way.
All right, Klein's going for another three attempt.
Ooh.
They're getting close, but not close enough.
She's now 1-for-4.
Vikings has got the ball.
Zoom back out a little bit. I mean, way too close there.
Yeah, they're trying to get someone open. They're going to try. They're going to drive in.
That's what happens when you leave them open. They can just drive straight in.
Exactly. There, go for a three attempt. Almost had it. Megan Evans with the rebound. There, bring it back. Layup. Missed.
She drew a foul.
All right. Does that set her up for two free throws? Yes, it does.
You're going to bring her to the line.
I think this is the first time she's been set up for free throws tonight. So let's see how she matches up.
Going to the line is a godsend.
Mm-hmm.
Because it slows down the tempo for your team and it gives you a chance to get 2 points on the board.
Oh, that had all the bounce in the world but didn't go in. All right, 0-for-1. Let's see her make the second one. And there we go. 1-1. Comet's now trailing only by 11 points. We can come back. Vikings trying to get open again. Comet's can't let them. They're going to pull for threes as soon as they get that opening. Or drive in.
She would have pulled that too.
Oh. Watch her. Watch her. I'm trying to pull it. Can't get an opening. Keep it. Oh, she went for the shot. Going there.
That was a lot of work for nothing.
Oh, ho, ho. Tried to get the rebound, but ended up stepping out. Comets have got the ball again now. Shane Lobb passes to Evans. Evans passes back to Shane Lobb. Oh, that was a risky pass. Over to Klein.
They're just not very selective with their passing. They try to go cross court, and it ends up in the enemy's hands.
Yeah. Trying to make him long, I guess. I don't know.
No foul there.
Oh, we had it. We had it. We tried to get it out, but it got swallowed out. Vikings have got the ball now. Oh, man.
Yeah.
Vikings trying to get set up. Comet's got to stay on that defense. That was a nice shot. Wasn't far back enough for a three.
For a three?
No, I said it wasn't far back enough for a
three. Okay.
Evans with the ball. Driving right in.
Floater.
Got nowhere. Almost rebounded by Krista. Got taken.
Out of nowhere. RKO. Well, that's not the right sport.
Comet's got to play good defense here. As soon as the Vikings are going to find it open, they're going to go for it. Like that. Nothing, though. Get the rebound. Come on, what are you doing?
Comets are just giving them all the room out inside the arc, and then they just drive in on them and shoot jumpers. And then
and they almost get it, and they get the rebound, and there's no one there to stop them.
Now Dakota with the weather.
Come on. Come on, Comets.
Ooh.
Bachelor over to Evans. Evans to Shainlob. Goes for the shot attempt. Doesn't get it. Vikings got the ball again. What kind of pass was that?
It was on the back shoulder. She couldn't control it.
No, not at all. That went right out. Comets got the ball. Oh, we got number 11, Emily Holt, subbing in for 20, Shainlob.
I've been really impressed with Emily over the course of this season. It's only been four games in.
I know. And she's only a freshman, which makes it even more impressive. But she's got the ball, too. So passing over
she's
to Bachelor.
Got them handles.
We got them handles. Passing over to Evans. Evans to Rowe. Lost control of it.
A little hard.
I think they're just trying to throw the passes a bit too far, too fast. And they're just, like, the reaction time isn't matching up for it.
They're trying to speed up the tempo, and it's not really going their way.
If you can't keep the tempo, don't speed it up. Vikings with the ball. Looking for an opening again. Went for the shot attempt. Nowhere. Rebound by Rowe.
Comets are allowing the Vikings to take their time with their shots, and that's just not how you... When the tempo is this slow, you try to speed it up, but... They're rushing
attempt.
It too fast.
They are. Vikings have the ball again. Taking it back around. They got it in. Nowhere.
What happens is, like in NBA, you'll see one team try to speed up the tempo as fast as possible, while the other team tries to slow it down as much as possible, and that's when you create a balanced tempo.
Yeah.
And that's when you get those close games when the tempo is that balanced.
Yeah.
When you see a team really pull ahead is when you see the tempo really speed up. It'll start being like a snowball. It starts kind of slow
rolling.
And it just keeps rolling and rolling. That's when you get those blowouts.
I never really noticed that till now, but now that I think about it, on previous NBA games I've watched, you are absolutely right. Number three, Evans with the layup. Nice. That'll get the momentum rolling. Now if we can just keep them from scoring. Watch them, ladies. As soon as they get open, they're going to drive for it. Or we'll go for the three. Or do that.
Just let them drive in right there.
Don't let them get the rebound. The rebound. Evans to Klein. Klein to Evans. Man, I'm sounding like a broken record. Evans to Klein gets stolen. Vikings looking to open it up again.
So now what you're seeing is North White is slowing down the tempo to their speed, and the Comets are trying to speed it back up.
But
they're rushing themselves, and that's when you get those turnovers.
They can't keep control of that tempo that they're trying to set. Was that three attempt? Yeah, it was. Wasn't watching her feet too close. Excuse me. Man.
What they're going to have to do is that they're going to have to... What I want to see them do, actually, is to go at their own pace and try to get back into this game as much as possible before the half is done, because it's the fourth quarter where you see all teams start rushing themselves, and that's when the big mistakes are made, and that's when big plays are made.
I couldn't agree more. Man, how come you're not commentating for the professionals, Maddox? We should put you on the mic more often.
I don't get paid enough.
I know you don't. All right, Batcher with the ball. Those are the Evans. Evans to Holt. Holt back to Evans. Once again, I'm sounding very repetitive. Evans to Holt. Holt goes for the shot. Nowhere. Hook tried to get in for the rebound. Couldn't get it.
Blue ball. blue ball.
Vikings trying to get an opening. Going for the shot attempt. She almost had it. Hook with the rebound kind of slid it into Evan's hands.
That one-man team again that I was talking about first time. When you weren't here, I made a very big statement when I was with Galen about one-man teams, one-man heroes that try to take the ball as fast as possible. It's good for a little bit. Like, you do it once, but after a while, you'll have a 1v5 on the other side of the court while the rest of the teammates are trying to catch up on the other side.
I can see it being helpful if when you get to the other side, you can actually, like, make the layup go into the hoop. But if you don't make it, then what's the point of going for that kind of a
drive?
That's
a waste of a possession. They're not using the team as much. They're not passing. Well, they are passing now, but their pass, they're not selective. They're
right.
aggressively passing.
Evans going for the three. Missed it. See, now, supposedly, that same game that I wasn't here, Evans was pulling threes, like, everywhere.
She was.
See, now I miss all the cool stuff. And I think that was like her second, third attempt, and she didn't make that one either.
Nope.
Man.
You shouldn't be here more often.
No one. Wow. You know, that's about to sound right. Whenever I'm here, we're not doing too well. Oh, nice steal by Holt. Bring it back. The layup.
Foul
she made it too. Might have got fouled on, but that was a straight rub in their face. Look what I can do. That was awesome.
She is a freshman.
She is a freshman. Way to call it out, student section. But she's up on the line. Impressive.
You can't really find many freshmen that try to take senior spots and make their way on the varsity team this early.
Oh yeah, definitely. One of a kind.
Because it wasn't like it's the end of the season and she's been doing this for a while. She has been doing this for a while, but she's just got that much skill and talent
that as a freshman she can play on the varsity and do stuff like that.
Yeah. She's a player that can shoot the ball and read where the ball is. And it looks like they're going to come to a standstill for the last 20 seconds of this. So
we're just going to have an intense stare down while waiting for the clock to tick down.
It's a Mexican standoff.
See, they didn't like that. They didn't like what Holt did. They don't want her to do anything else.
Oh. Pull it.
Do something. Just throw it. Oh, they're going to try and do something. They're going to try and go for a three. Yeah, they are. Missed it. Way to go. All right, well, that's going to put us at the end of the second quarter and send us into halftime. Thank you all for watching RTC TV. We'll be right back with you after the break.
And we're back after halftime,
well,
in case
scary.
You forgot.
That's a lost track of time.
Almost didn't make it in time after the halftime time ran out. Yeah, I know words. But in case you forgot, my name is Dakota Hayden. Alongside with me, one of my great friends and co-commentator and also cameraman for tonight, so that means he's getting paid double, Weenie, Maddox Sider. Comments are trailing here tonight, 15-31. That's okay.
Say trailing?
Yeah, they're trailing.
They're not trailing.
Yeah, they are. They're behind.
That's not trailing.
Well, what is it to be behind then?
Behind.
Okay, now you're getting technical with me. I think we can make a comeback in the second half. But then again, whenever I say that, we tend to not. So I'm going to say we're not and see what happens. I'm hoping that means we do and that I'm biased.
Well, you know this scientific rule of, you know what they say about assuming.
Isn't that some kind of like Murphy's Law thing where like everything evens out?
No, Murphy's Law is everything that can go wrong will go wrong.
Oh. Well, then isn't there another law that like evens it? Isn't that like the rule of thirds or something like that?
That's a physics law, and it's with every action, there's an equal and opposite reaction.
I'm not talking about the technical thing. I'm going to look this up when I get home and just school you.
Oh, really? When we're not on cam, so nobody will know?
Absolutely. The best way to... Ooh. Oh, they had a nice three. The best way to school someone is through word of mouth. I can spread rumors. You don't know. All right, Comet's got the ball. Lincoln Evans, number three. Tossing it to Hook. Throwing it to Klein, back to Hook, and then to Evans, then to Holt. Man, this is so fast, I can't keep up. Then over to Evans, then to Hook, then to Klein. Klein driving in. Ooh, missed the shot. Vikings got the ball. Kind of keeping the pace a little bit slow this time around, but then again, we just started the third quarter, so I'm not going to say too much.
I don't really like I don't really like filming the corners of the court because, let's face it, they never actually shoot it. They just kind of pass it right back out. So I'm like, I go over there, I'm like, oh, they're probably going to shoot it, and they pass it right back. I'm like, oh, God, no. So I, like, jerk the camera around, and I feel really dumb. Oh, but not as dumb as that. What did you just do, Megan? Come on.
Well, as far as your camera skills go, we haven't had any complaints yet, so don't take that as a message to all you viewers at home to complain about our work.
The only people that have complained about my work at home is me.
Oh, so you're a self-critic. I am, too.
Someone has to be a critic of me.
Exactly. I can barely stand
it. My mom
myself.
Is not filling the budget anymore. She's lacking now. Ever since I'm getting ready to turn 18, she's been like...
Three attempts and a half? No, three attempts. Man, is my voice really sounding that bad? We just completely lost track of what we were talking about.
Mom budgets.
No, my mother critiques me every morning. Get out of bed, you lazy slob. Okay, Mom.
I'm going to school, Mom. Never come back. Thanks, Mom.
Is that number 21? No, it's 22 up on the line.
Number 13 just came in for number 12, Bailey Hook. Number 13.
Bachelor. Well, she made the shot.
I want to listen to Sweet Caroline now.
Just because the student section can sing it doesn't mean you need to listen to it. And they are great at singing songs, I tell you what.
Oh, yeah. They should be choir.
Okay, who had that three attempt on our team? Was that Shane Lobb? She tried for the three?
Yes.
Or was that Bachelor? No, that's Shane Lobb.
And she boxed out and didn't go for the ball, which is kind of weird, but, you know, I'm not judging. I don't play basketball, so I don't know what I'm talking about.
You know a tad bit more than I do. Mostly on fouls, though. Vikings looking for an opening. If they find it, they'll take it. We've seen it. Especially that number four over there. Ooh, oh, stolen by Holt.
Another one.
Run it back. Layup. She got it. That's ridiculously impressive. That's the second time she's done that. Vikings make a score. Trying to stay ahead of the Comets. If we can get that momentum rushing, we should be able to score point after point nonstop.
Gotta keep that opposite tempo, but you can't go too overboard or else you're gonna keep messing up.
Yeah. Evans with the drive in. No one on the rebound. Oh, Bachelor's got it. Pass it to Holt. And back to Bachelor. Where were you on that one, Bachelor?
There's always a bad side to a tempo. Slow tempo, you're gonna run out of time a lot quicker. Well, not quicker, but you know what I mean. You're gonna run out of time.
And fast, you just sometimes lose control of the ball.
Oh, you don't have any control over anything.
Unless you have really quick reflexes and you can keep, you know, tabs on everything. But not everyone has that. Very rarely will you find five people that can be in tone at that quick of a pace.
It's true. The good teams are the ones that can do both.
Exactly.
Can do it all.
Shane loved a Bachelor.
You can
Bachelor
go really
Evans.
Fast and keep control of the ball. You can go really slow and still have enough time to do everything.
Stolen.
Hold Emily Holt.
Man, we should have saw her coming. She was running to steal that ball. All right, Evans over to Bachelor. And then back to Evans. And driving in, passing it back out to Holt. Going around to Evans. Man, I'm getting tired of listening to myself talk about how the ball is getting passed around. Holt back out to Evans. Evans in to Klein. That was a risky pass. Klein goes for the shot, doesn't make it.
We're full of risky passes right now.
Yeah, I know, but like the more particular risky ones, like over the top of the head of a Viking.
A Viking.
Made that shot. Ah, man, they got 40 on the board now.
40 bomb.
They got Evan C. like that. That's why I call that a risky shot, because they'll just jump up and grab it. And do that. Oh, wait, they missed. Never mind. That's okay.
Only pass over the head and we can catch him sleeping.
Nobody there. I mean, you might have been looking for Holt, but when there's three Vikings on top of her, you can't get it to her.
I think that was a 360 layup.
Wow. Pro.
Pro emoji.
All right, Evans.
Ooh,
pass the ball over to Batchelor.
Still going to pass.
Yeah, fake pass. It just still does the
pass. One thing you'd never want to do in basketball is get in a rut, get in a habit of something. Because then the team's going to pick it right back up. Pick it up, you know what I mean.
Not to diss on our football team, but kind of like how we did with all those running plays that we did in football, but the other teams kind of
caught on. That was football. This is basketball season.
I know
it's different.
I know it's different, but the same concept applies. Yeah, number 24, Allie Weiss, subbing in for 20, Shane Love.
We're going to win, folks. We're going to win. We're going to win so much. We're going to be tired of winning. And when we're tired of winning, we're going to win some more.
Why do you say such things when it's obviously not true at the moment?
I was quoting our president.
Oh, yeah. Sure.
Well, before he was president, but he's still president now.
I was going to compliment how the student section is, like, serenading our ears with the songs of Journey. A hole. What the shot. Nice. That was a three. She could do more of that. We can get those momentum swinging for us, and we can just start slam-bamming, man. Vikings on the rebound. Come on, Comets, get in there. Get in there on the rebound. Four's going to go for a three if you let her.
Have you ever watched an NBA game?
Yeah.
You ever notice that when the team's like down, they start getting down like 10, 12, 14, maybe 16 points?
Yeah.
Around there. There'll be a person, like a point guard, that runs up and they'll pull a three and they'll splash it. And then you see all the crowd, even if they're not on the, like, not on your side, like on that team's side, they stand up. Because everyone loves it when someone charges down and they just pull a three like that.
Yeah.
And everyone's standing up and they're all clapping. And that's when you start getting the momentum back. And that's when you can start rolling in.
Exactly.
We had two threes back to back right there with no score. We're getting on a roll.
Let's keep it going. The more we can kind of snowball this momentum, the more points we can score.
They call it streak.
Streak, yeah. That seems like a very appropriate word for that.
That's what it is.
Comets ball. Coach Helmick applauding the ladies' Comets. Nice kind of rush of momentum here.
That's why he's not calling timeout, because he's starting to get the momentum back.
Exactly. Why would you call a timeout? If you start to get the flow going, you know, the adrenaline pumping.
I'm just waiting for the Vikings coach to call it.
He's just going to go.
Because when you call a timeout, that shuts everything down. It's all over.
Exactly. That's putting me into perspective of saying how much that there is to, like, strategic timeout calls. Because if you think
but
about
it. But sometimes you gotta waste your timeouts when things aren't going your way. You got to call a timeout, get everyone back together, and tell them, hey.
And then other times you use it just to kind of throw off the other team when they got a roll going and hope that it slows them down.
Yep.
Vikings on the rebound. They got the ball again. And they lost it.
Woo.
Oh, boy. They're going to get it back into play here. Watch them. Run, ladies, watch them. They get open. They're going to go for it. Got in the paint. And the score. Well, we're at least double behind. I don't know what that means, but that's what we are.
You mean at least double? We're exactly double behind.
I know. Set her up for a three. Come on, get open. Holt. Oh, someone on the rebound. Come on, Evans. Throws it back in. No one there to bounce off of Evans. Throw back in for the I'm saying words and I don't even know what I'm saying. I've lost track.
It's what the environment and feeling of being in a gym during a basketball game is like. Could you imagine an NBA game?
It'd just be nuts to be at one of those.
Oh, it'd be so nuts. I think I went to one game. I think it was a Pacers game. Oh,
yeah. I was straight swatted.
Oh, if she would have made that, would have been over.
Yeah. That was nasty. That'll bring us to the end
of the
third.
I would have put down the microphone and just be like, I'm out. I don't care about my pay anymore. I do care about my pay.
I need my money. Well, this is fun doing it anyway. Yeah, I'd probably do it.
The one downside. Is that Trenton Howard?
Where?
Is that Trenton Howard and
out
Dawson?
There with the cheerleaders?
Yeah.
Yes,
Trenton Howard
is.
And Dawson all over.
Oh, they're going to participate in the spelling of the comments.
Oh, I'm glad we can get those. We're getting a nice view.
Yeah.
In a sarcastic way, not in an actual way.
Oh, man. But, yeah, what we were saying before about being at an NBA game, I haven't been at one myself, but I think, the intensity of the crowd and everything, that'd be nuts. That'd be something that gets your heart pumping and your blood rushing and probably blow out your eardrums depending on the crowd.
That's true.
Be about as equivalent to sitting in the bass section of a concert.
Well, yeah, could you imagine the stadium when Golden State blew a 3-1 lead?
Oh, yeah.
Or when the Indians blew a 3-1 lead. That's baseball, though.
Yeah.
Shout out to all those Cubs fans out there. It's only been 108 years.
Wow.
It's like the Ottoman Empire was still, you know, around when the Cubs last won. They actually were. They were still
they
around.
Did.
They were still a thing.
At least they finally broke the losing streak.
Well, my mom was actually crying when that happened, when we won.
Yeah.
Oh, she was bawling. Because she loves the Cubs. She's been a Cubs fan since day one. My grandpa actually has bricks from Wrigley Field.
That's cool.
Family's always been Cubs family, and they finally won. I'm glad I got to be. I'm only 17.
You're only 17?
I still have a chance to get another one.
Yeah, you do. Or it could be another 108. You never know. Well, anyway, to catch back up on the action, Holt missed a three, and there was a really bad pass by the Vikings.
And better news, I got a cookie.
Oh, fantastic.
Havsies.
Oh, yeah. Oh, perfect. Timeout.
Sugar cookies, man. Got to keep up that blood level. You know, I donated blood the other day, and they told me my blood pressure was a little too high. So I kind of made the joke out of it and told them my SATs were the week before, so that's probably why. The doctor didn't laugh, but I did.
That's funny, though, because it's so true.
I was very nervous for the SATs.
They weren't that bad taking it the second time around. First time, I remember, spending, a good half an hour prepping for them.
Good half hour.
And then the second time, I just didn't even care. I barely even had my pants on walking out the door to go to the test.
I just didn't care. Oh, yeah, because half an hour
is
so much better.
And then I scored better than the first time. It was
I spent 14 days, 2 weeks preparing for that thing. You spent 30 minutes.
Yeah. Just shows how much time you need to use to prepare when you got all that confidence.
I swear, if you scored higher than me, I'm going to be so mad.
We'll find out.
Ooh.
Oh, that shot attempt got blocked.
You got a pumper. Draw a foul. Let's go. Ashton Klein's going to take it out. He's going to pass it right. Pull in a corner three right there.
Let's go.
Splash.
Nice.
That's what I saw when you were out. That's what I saw all day.
Well, let's get her going on him again. I want to see more. Give me more. Oh, they're going to try and counter. Get the rebound, Comets. Come on. There you go, Evans. Let's go.
This is when you get on that streak.
There she go. Oh, no.
That was a nice play by number four, though. That was a really nice play to read that.
Barely caught that one. Or by caught it, I mean swatted. And by swatted, I mean just knocked it out of play. You know, take it whatever.
You switched the three different meanings of that.
I don't.
The same word. Pretty much same word.
Holt. Oh, she was open to make that shot. She would have been a tad quicker. The 3 to 13 to 21. We all know their names.
We all know their names.
I hope, anyway.
Blocked again by number four.
She's on top of that. Not afraid of the ball.
Why would you be?
I don't know. Well, considering I do play basketball frequently with, you guys and stuff like that, reason, yeah. I got these glasses I do now is because the basketball broke for my old ones.
Well,
so,
whose fault's that?
Not mine. Actually, we'll blame the glasses manufacturer, and I won't say who they are so that way I don't get yelled at. But I love my thick frames. Totally not sponsored.
I just wear contacts. It's just that much easier.
I don't think I could ever get past putting them in my eyes.
Oh, no, it's painful. No. Especially when you get dirt in. Oh, dear Lord.
Ooh, Collins got the ball.
I don't usually cry, but it's just one of those things where it's just like, I have to. I have to cry to get the dirt out.
Exactly.
And sometimes when you don't have any water available, you have to put it in your mouth. Oh, yeah. It's disgusting. I hate contacts, but I wear them.
Nice.
Plus, you can also get diseases from them if you're leaving them in too long.
That
I'm going
on
a week. I'm sorry. Month six.
Ew. Well, if you get some kind of real bad eye disease or something like that, don't come crying.
I've already got astigmatism. I'm over.
All right. Well, that was a bad pass in the play before this. They're trying to get open into the paint.
Ooh, nice swat.
Nice. And we're able to get it before getting out. Oh, we got out. They got it back.
Oh.
She did get swatted, though. That's about all that counts there.
I mean, you win some, you lose some.
All right. Three, Evans passing over to Batchelor. And back to Evans. And over to Klein. And could have gone for the three, but not going for it. Passing over to Batchelor.
We're actually in the fourth quarter. And
a hold. And a Batchelor. And Evans.
Time flies, man.
And I'm tired of listening to myself. Goes for three. Oh, she nails that one.
All day.
Let's go. Let's go. Let's go. Like five more. Come on.
Like five more.
Atta girl.
Oh, you see Eli right there. You see Eli getting carted off the court.
He just done fainted. She's so good.
He done.
All right. Man, these coughing fits, I'm done with them.
Don't get cold.
I try not
Simple
to.
Simple as that. Simple as that.
I try not to.
Build up your immune system by injecting yourself like twice a day with cold. Even though there's so many strains of like the cold and the flu that it's literally impossible to do that, but still, do it.
You make so much sense but so little sense at the same time. It's baffling.
That's how you build up a immunity, but you can't build up an
because
immunity.
the same goes for like building up an immunity to gunshot wounds. You start with small calibers and you work your way up. Eventually you can take a 50 cal bullet to the chest without even blinking. Don't try that at home
because your head will be off.
That's why I left the disclaimer.
Disclaimer. Don't try this at home.
Do not.
Yeah, there's so many different genes of the cold that it's literally impossible to build up an immunity to it because there's just so many different strands and genes that they can develop. It's like the lottery, except you never win.
Oh, exactly.
Which is basically the lottery.
In a nutshell.
That's why when I turn 18, the first thing I'm not going to do... Wait, I'm not going to do is buy a winning lottery ticket.
I haven't done that yet. I'm 18.
Huh?
I thought I'd do it for fun, but I haven't bought a lottery ticket yet myself.
Don't. It's a ripoff.
I don't usually ever do that. Well, that was a really long pass.
It's cross court. The CC pass right there. Shoot
well,
it.
Aren't you technical? Driving in, going for a shot.
Shot.
Ooh.
Ooh. 50 bomb.
50 bomb. Let's see. If I can do math, which isn't common, we're 21 points down. That's 7 threes. We can do that. Just give them all to number 3, Evans.
Or Emily.
Or Emily, yeah. That'll work too.
Pull. Or anyone, actually. They can all pull them. There's
yeah,
really
they can
any.
All do it. It's just you got to get them open.
Of course,
I got confused when you said Emily because both Emilys are on the court right now.
That's very true. I did not know that.
Either way, they can both score the points.
They're both doing really well tonight, but number 3 and number 11 are doing the best.
Oh, yeah. They're nailing the threes.
No, not even nailing
and
threes.
And also, yeah, and
they're
also.
Doing very well on defense, too.
Yeah.
There's a lot of turnovers between the both of them.
I was just stating facts.
I know you were. I was expanding on your facts.
Okay.
Okay. Don't get offended.
I don't, but it's 2016. I can get away with a lot nowadays, can't I? Number 3, Evans. Pass to Holt. She goes for the 3.
Oh, nothing but net.
Oh, but rebounded to Emily. Or Rowe.
Another
rebounded again.
Way to draw the foul there.
That would have been awesome.
Take her to the line.
I'm okay with taking
nice
her to the line.
It stops the clock, too.
It does.
But it also slows the tempo, and that's not what. Well, it is what they want now because there's only 3 minutes and 25 seconds left in the fourth. So you can't really speed up. You can't really slow down the tempo unless you want to lose.
Point. Oh, nice. Is this Klein's first time up for three free throws? I do believe so.
I don't know.
So that's 1-0, I think. If not, I'll watch this back over and like yell at myself because I'm dumb. Ah, 2-0, supposedly. Probably. Oh, that was a nice swat. Holt almost had that steal right there. Didn't exactly have it, but that would have been nice. Number four's got it. Watch her. She'll go for the three. Or she'll just drive straight in. Well, just don't give any of them an opening. Because the logical thing to do is if you have an opening to go for it. Evans on the rebound lost it. Got to have a little bit more control like that. Vikings looking for an opening, driving in. It's going to be a foul and give them the two. Bring them to the line.
Bring them to the line.
It's not helping us, but let's hope she's bad.
Let's hope she's bad.
I mean, why not? It's looking so.
No, that was actually pretty close. It'll just bounce off the rim, you know. It's not.
I don't even think it was. It was kind of just aiming for the left side of the rim.
She's going to readjust herself. And
Yeah, obviously. But, you know, we're on the opposing team. And I just don't want her to make it. Nothing against her. She's probably a nice lady.
The golden rule is you can miss one of your free throws, but you can't miss the second one.
Because obviously you should know to adjust.
You got to adjust.
Bachelor passed it to Rowe. Getting in there. Go for it. Get it. Nice. Nice shot. Bringing us 33. North White still got 50, but hey, we got 33.
But hey. But hey.
Vikings looking for that opening. Student section of ours just daring the Vikings to shoot it.
Daring?
They are. You hear them? Oh, rebound. Going for the... Get it. Come on, Rowe. Get it out of there. Nice. Pass it to Evans. Bringing it back around.
Get out to Holt. Like, pull that. Actually,
to Rowe. Oh, come on. Get it in there. Yeah. Keep that momentum flowing, girls. We got 2 minutes to do something awesome.
This is what they're going to do. They're going to slow down the tempo, keep it, try to wear out as much as possible because they still have to get 15 points in a minute 50.
15 points. That's only like what? Five threes?
It's a five-possession game.
I know. Get over to Klein. Go for the three. Oh, that hurts my soul. Oh, that was in, but it just circled. Oh.
Makes your heart skip, doesn't it?
Oh, I was looking awesome.
You ever watch NCAA basketball?
Yeah.
Did you watch the finals for that, March Madness?
I don't think I got to the finals of March Madness.
Villanova hit a buzzer beater against North Carolina.
Oh, yeah. The final seconds. I remember hearing about that.
Could you imagine being the Sands for that one?
Oh, you don't even know. That'd be nuts. At the rebound. Still makes a shot.
Timeout with a minute left.
A minute exactly, too.
Timeout. Oh, it was a foul.
I didn't even catch the foul.
I didn't catch the foul either. I just saw him do the timeout, the kind of like timeout. Oh, yeah. It might have been. Oh, it was a technical.
That's rare.
Uh-oh.
For us, that's rare.
Huh?
For us, that's rare.
That's already happened once a season.
I haven't seen it. Oh. Okay.
You weren't there, man.
Exactly. I know.
You got a concert to go to. Two shots. You know what technical foul is, right?
Educate me.
Two shots and you get the ball back.
Oh.
Technical or is it intentional?
Technical is an intentional foul, so they meant to do it.
They meant to do it.
Yeah.
Or it was a very, very serious foul.
Right.
It's not even a personal foul.
So, like, would if, like, the opposing team member just completely pushed one of our girls down, would that be technical?
Yes.
Okay.
Or it would be unsportsmanlike conduct.
That too.
Or if one of them started a fight, you know.
Yeah.
Both of those players would be ejected, but then... Oh, wait, they would cancel each other out because both players are actually... If one just gets wailed on, I mean...
Okay. I get what you're saying. Bachelor's got to get over to Holt driving in. Bachelor going for the three. Going for the rebound. Come on, girls, turn this around. They're going to try and wear out the clock.
45 seconds left. I don't think this is going to be very good for the lead comms here. They had a chance.
They had nice momentum flowing. Oh, come on, Holt, get in there. She hesitated a little bit. She was there. She could have just stole it and just ran for it. Man, this is a good game.
It's I really not don't like it.
As I would want it to, but I'm like, I'm hyped.
Sure. I really don't like it when they sub in for like the last 30 seconds, because that just
by that time it's just to get play time in.
It's just get 30 seconds of play time. I mean, seriously.
I know.
That was a timeout. Was that full timeout? I'm pretty sure it was a full timeout. I'm not real sure. It's called by the comments though.
Well, either way,
tell them what you got to do. But this is the time where they put in like the second string, the third string. It's basically just to wear out the clock. I mean, they take out all their starters, give them a little bit of rest, but
might as well use them.
This is
the
most valuable time for the second, third string. See if you can do anything. Nothing really hypes you more like when you get put in the last 10 seconds and you hit like a half quarter.
Oh, that's when the crowd just goes nuts.
Especially for the win.
Oh yeah, definitely.
But if it was for the win, they would keep in their starters because you don't want it to be close.
Right. Alright. Watch it, Evans. Pass it to Holt.
30
Send
seconds
it
left.
To Klein, get it to Holt. Over to Batchelor. Easy, keep control of that.
Send Can't keep hold on to it.
Get it to Holt. No. Easy. And Evans again. Going for behind the board shot. What was that?
It took him long enough to blow that whistle.
I were confused on what she was trying to do.
They're like, what? I swear the ref looked at the ball like, what is this? How did I even get here?
Oh, wait, this is basketball?
I was calling volleyball fouls the entire time.
Yeah, Vikings are going to hold on to that and finish it off.
2-1-0.
All right, ladies and gentlemen, well, thank you for tuning in to RTC TV4. Feel free to check out our Facebook, our YouTube, anything that you can get onto. Check out our website and see other videos. Once again, my name is Dakota Hayden along with Maddox Sider, and we will see all you guys next week.